In this question, we are given that two electrons are moving with non-relativistic speeds perpendicular to each other. And if corresponding de Broglie wavelengths are lambda 1 and lambda 2 for these two electrons, then their de Broglie wavelength in the frame of reference attached to their center of masses, that's what we are required to calculate. So here in solution, if we visualize the case, we are having two electrons traveling perpendicular to each other, say with the speeds v1 and v2. So we can see if there is a center of mass for the two electrons, then speed of center of mass, or more precisely we should write vector speed or velocity of center of mass of this two electron system is given as, here velocity of center of mass we can write as m, mass of electron is same for the two, mv1 vector plus mv2 vector divided by m plus m, that gives half of v1 vector plus v2 vector. In this case, as we have v1 vector is equals to v1 I cap, if we consider this to be x and this to be y direction, then v2 vector is v2 j cap. And as the de Broglie wavelengths are given, we also use lambda 1 is h over mv1, and we use lambda 2 as h over mv2. So in this case we are getting v1 as h by m lambda 1, this h by m lambda 1 I cap, and this h by m lambda 2 j cap. So substituting the values here, we are getting velocity of center of mass is half of v1 plus v2, we can substitute. So here h by m gets common and we are getting 1 by lambda 1 I cap plus 1 by lambda 2 j cap. This is what we are getting for the velocity of center of mass. Now we are required to find the de Broglie wavelength of these electrons, or any of these electrons, because as per language the two must be coming out as equal values. So here it can be given as h by mv of electron with respect to center of mass. So first we calculate in reference frame of center of mass velocity of first electron traveling in x direction is given as, here velocity of first electron in the frame of center of mass we can write it as v1 vector minus vc vector, that we can calculate here by substituting the values of v1 and vc. This gives us velocity of first electron in the frame of center of mass, v1 we already calculated as h by m lambda 1 I cap minus velocity of center of mass we can put here, which is h by 2m lambda 1 I cap plus h by 2m lambda 2 j cap. Simplifying here, we are getting the value of v1c vector as this h by, because these two values are I cap, subtracting this giving h by 2m lambda 1 I cap minus h by 2m lambda 2 j cap. So now we can calculate the magnitude of velocity of first electron in the frame of center of mass. So here h by 2m gets common and we are getting this as root of 1 by lambda 1 square plus 1 by lambda 2 square. We are just calculating the magnitude of the vector. As we have got the velocity, the speed of a first electron in the frame of center of mass, this speed of first electron in frame of central mass. So we can now calculate de Broglie wavelength of first electron in central mass frame is given as your lambda of first electron in central mass frame, we can write h by momentum in the frame of central mass is mv1c. If we substitute it, this is giving us h by m multiplied by, here we are getting this as 1 by h by 2m times root of 1 by lambda 1 square plus 1 by lambda 2 square. Numerically solving, here h by m gets cancelled out, this giving us twice of lambda 1 lambda 2 by root of lambda 1 square plus lambda 2 square. And you can see this value matches with option C. And as the symmetric for both lambda 1 and lambda 2, that has also been verified that even for second electron we are getting the same result. So answer to this question will be getting as option C.